Just a couple weeks ago, in early June 2025, Airtable kind of slid a new feature out there under the radar. They have now enabled self-linking tables to have backlinks, which means if you're in a single table and you link back to that table so that it's self-linking, you will see two fields now, two linked relationships, when you link from one thing to the other and then the reciprocal of that link. This is a brand new feature that unlocks a lot of new potential for us, as I will demonstrate in this video. So if learning more about this self-linking table is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's my mission here to help you to unlock the full potential of Airtable and related no-code tools. And in this video, as I said, we're going to be breaking down this brand new self-linking table with backlinks. It's always been possible that we could self-link to a table, but it's only recently that we could see the dependencies on that backlink. And we're going to demonstrate that in this video. But before we get to it, I first want to invite you to join me for some free templates. If you sign up at gapconsulting.io/templates, I will invite you to see the 5 most common templates that we use in and out of our most regular projects. Now, in full transparency, we usually build things from the ground up, but I've put these templates together for you because they are requested time and time again, and it will help you start implementing Airtable in various new ways. So grab those templates for free at the link provided. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen, and here I am inside of a brand new database. You can see I just started it, I named it New Base, and I only have the one table. Now, let's imagine probably one of the more popular scenarios that you would get for self-linking tables, and that is tasks. So I will rename this table. And you know, what kind of stuff comes on a task? We have the task name, maybe we have a due date. We'll use the date field obviously and name this due date. We'll have other things like who is that task assigned to, so we'll bring in a user. And usually like some sort of a priority, and of course, most importantly, a status. So I'll skip priority, but I'll bring in the status field here. And we can have something like, let's say in progress, overdue and complete, just as, you know, some simple examples, right? You can color code these, as I'm sure you're aware, if you are an Airtable user. And of course, you can do a lot of fun things with the way that you put together some different views and interfaces. So you can filter based on certain status, you can color code your records, all kinds of things. But for our purpose here, let's just pick some simple colors and create these fields and then put together a few simple tasks. Task 1, task 2, and task 3. And then I'll just throw in some due dates. Let's go 17th here, 20th, and lastly, 24th. Now, I'll just assume that all of these are getting assigned to me for the sake of this example. And we'll track the status here, let's say in progress, for all three of them. Now, it's for a while been possible that we could self-link to a table. So when you have things like tasks in particular, it's a common thing to want to self-link because you might have dependencies. So you would say something like dependent on. And in order to present this, you're going to self-link to the tasks table. And so I'll name this dependent on. And of course, let's assume that task 3, for our example, is dependent on task 1 and task 2. If that's the case, then we would want to enable allowing multiple records, because this then says, you know, I can link multiple things here. And I can do more advanced things with my linking. I could say only certain views are available, only conditions. I can even use some AI if you have AI enabled in your workspace. But for our purposes, we want to focus on this new backlink. So let's just keep it here. Allow linking to multiple records, and I'm going to create this field. And now this is the brand new thing that we never had before. This self-linking table, this self-linking backlink is now available. And so it's this from field. You'll notice I only created the one linked relationship, but the reciprocal of that is now created. Now, this is the interesting thing, right? Just if we're speaking conceptually, in the past, when we would link two tables, say table A to table B, then when you build a link in one, the reciprocal is present in the other table. So if you link, let's say, projects to tasks as an example, tasks are automatically at the same time linked to projects. This has always been the case in Airtable for the last 10 years, as long as I've been using the software. But here's where things are interesting. When we self-linked a table, in this case, tasks are linked to tasks, well, it was not always the case that we got the backlink. And so this is the new feature. But you can click on this and kind of get a view here, like, okay, well, we are linking back here, and we could rename this and say, dependent to, I don't know what the right terminology would be, but let's just use that. But watch the cool thing about this, right? It works just like a backlink in any other table. So in our example, we said task three is dependent on 1 and 2. So let's select them from the list. As I'm selecting them, you see the reciprocal of the relationship being linked here. So if I said task three is dependent on 1, well then 1 is dependent to or dependent for task 3. And so that's what you're seeing represented on that backlink. And we can go in here and do the same thing for this. Now, you might ask yourself, what is the value for this? And there are a number of use cases where this could be really helpful. Example one, imagine you have an org chart, the organizational structure of a company or an organization. Well, who is reporting to whom? You know, you have this idea that, you know, who are your managers? And you have a link to the people in the same table that are your managers. But the reciprocal is now going to be demonstrated as well. So if I had 5 people reporting to me in the company, I would have in the other field who I'm managing. And so you can see the reciprocal of that relationship quite clearly. Another great example is what you see before you here. Dependent tasks, especially when you're employing Gantt charts in your interfaces and Airtable views, this is really important to see. Not only do you now see what the task is dependent on, but you see what other tasks are relying on this to be completed. So we can see at a glance now that we need to complete task 1 in order for task 3 to be ready, or in order for it to be possible to complete, because it's relying on us to complete 1 and task 2, because you can see the dependency here. So these types of examples are plentiful. We can think of a lot of wiki pages that we might create with Airtable data, saying that people wrote multiple articles and what articles were they written by, and rolling that back up. Many, many self-linking relationships that we've needed automations in the past in order to create this functionality. And now it's readily available at a glance. Now, a couple of warnings or flags on the field to be aware of. If you have an old Airtable database that had a self-linking table, if you just log in, you will not have that brand new field. In order to get that brand new field, you have to build that link again, because it would seem that when Airtable turned this feature on, older links, self-linking tables, they did not automatically inherit this new function or this new feature. So if you want that functionality, you have to go back and rebuild that linked relationship inside of your table. And this might create some pause for you, some trepidation, because if you have any automations, any interfaces tied to that old linked relationship, you're going to break those as soon as you start messing around with it. So be thoughtful about this. If you really need the function, great, go back into your old stuff and add it. Note that you have to add it in order to get it. But from here on out, any new things you build that are self-linking, it's going to come inherited just as you saw. Now, one question I have seen from folks is it possible to not have the backlink? From what I can tell, that's not possible. But does it really matter? All we have to do is hide it. If you don't like the backlink, just hide it. Don't include it in your interfaces. Think of it as a bonus. If you want it, it's there, but you don't need to use it if it's not the way that you want to work. So I hope you got a ton of value from this video. I'm excited about this new feature because it allows us to just build smarter, better things when we're self-linking in Airtable. I hope you agree, but leave your comments below. Whatever your feedback is, whether positive or negative, we would love to hear it in the comments of the video. Of course, if you have questions that we did not answer, swing by our website. We've put a ton of resources together for you, for your disposal, to help you build better in Airtable. But most importantly, my friends, keep on building.